In this video, I explain the layout of modern steam power plant. In a modern steam power plant, there is a number of components is there. Okay, so this diagram is little bit complicated. For make it simple, I use this animation so you will understand it easily. And I definitely give guarantee that you can understand this modern steam power plant very easily by watching this video. For sake of simplicity, we divide this diagram in a four circuit. First circuit is coal to S circuit. Second one is the air to flue gas circuits. Okay. And we also compare this modern steam power plant with our human body. So you will understand it easily. Third circuit is the water to steam circuit, means water is converted into the steam. Okay. And the fourth circuit is the cooling water circuit. Okay, so in our human body, that is a different part is there and they are performing the different functions. Okay, so first we know we are drinking some water. Okay, and the drinking water is coming out in some other forms. Okay, they are coming in the waters by getting some impurities from our body. We eat some food. Okay, so our food is the food for the steam power plant is a coal. Okay, and this food is discharged in a form of a S. In human body, we eat some foods and we discharge in the morning. Okay, some in the other forms. We inhale the air. Okay, so same way here in this boiler, you see that is a air is there and air is converted into flue gas. In our human body, we take the air and removing the CO2. We eat the foods and food is coming out. Means our food circuit is compared with the coal and S circuit. Our air inhalation system is compared with this air and the flue gas circuit. And the water and steam circuit is compared with this our drinking waters. Okay, so water is supplied to the stomach and this kidney is removing some of the water with impurities. Okay, and the fourth circuit is the cooling water circuits. Okay, so our human body is also required the cooling systems. So generally our human body is cool with respect to the atmosphere, or sometimes we use the air conditioning system to maintain our human body temperatures down. Okay, so you can relate these four human circuits with this modern steam power plant, so you will understand it very easily. Okay, so what we do, for a sake of simplicity, we divide into four main circuits. Just I repeat these four names. First one is the coal and S circuit, that is similar as what we eat, means we take the foods and removing some byproducts. Another is the air and flue gases circuit. So air and flue gas circuit is compared with this our human body, that is the air inhalation systems. Third is the feed water and steam circuit. Okay, so we drink water, they supply to stomach, then go to the kidney, and then finally we remove it from our body with some impurities. And the cooling water circuit. So our human body is cooled by the atmosphere air, or sometimes we cool it by using the air conditioning systems. So now first we understand the coal and S circuits. Okay, so this name is given according to which basis. So we supplied the coal to the furnace as an input, and when this burning of coal is going on, at that time some flue gases is produced, and at the end of the burning of coal some byproduct is there and its name is the S. Okay, so this name is given according to this input and output, means coal is input and output is the S. So this is the boiler. In a boiler, the one component is that is a furnace. Okay, in a furnace we supply a coal, and the coal is combusts, means the combustion of the coal is carried out in the presence of air. Okay, so how the coal is supplied to this boiler? Okay, they are not directly supplied to this boiler, there is a number of stages is there in between. So coal received in a coal storage yard of a power station is transferred to the furnace by coal handling plants. Okay, means one coal handling plant is there to transferring the coal from a storage yard to the boiler. So after necessary preparation of the coal, from coal handling plant is taken to the boiler bunkers by means of the bucket conveyors, and then the coal is stored in the bunkers. Okay, means first the coal is unloading. Okay, means suppose the one power plant is there. In a one power plant, the coal is coming by the railway lines. Okay, so first we need to remove the coal, means we need to do the unloading of a coal from the wagons. Okay, for that the wagon tripler mechanism is used that we study in a main components. Okay, if you don't know the main components, then it is very difficult for you to understand this layout. Okay, so I request you to watch this component of the modern steam power plants and its functions, then it is very easy to understand this layout. Okay. For this component and its functions, I provide this link in descriptions as well as in a card. So I request to watch that video. Okay. So first the unloading of the coal is done by using the wagon tripler mechanisms. Then the coal preparation is there. Means there is a crusher house is there. In a crusher house, we reduce the size of coal. Okay. And even we do the drying process on the coal because the coal is contained the more moistures. Okay. And then after the coal is stored. Okay. Now from this storage, the coal is supplied to the boiler by using this bucket conveyor. Okay. So that is the one types of the conveyor is there. On this conveyor belt, that is the buckets are fitted. Okay. So from this bucket, this coal is transferred to the bunkers. Okay. So that is a coal handling plant is there. Coal handling plant means that is a bucket conveyor is there. So by using this conveyor, the coal is supplied to the boiler furnace. Okay. So it is finally supplied to these boilers. Okay. So coal from the bunkers fall into the hopper by gravity. Okay. So that is a hopper is one component. From the hoppers, the coal is supplied to the furnace by gravity. And finally, the requisite quantity of coal either goes up falling directly on a grate. Now what is a grate? Means grate is the location on which the combustion of the coal is carried out. It is called as the grate. Or where the coal is spreads are provided. Coal is spread in a grate up to a rear end with this help of the coal spreaders. So in a furnace, one part is there, that is a grate. Grate means it is a one types of the grill is there. On the grill the coal is putted and this combustion of the coal is carried out. And after completing these combustions, the some product are left and this product are called a S. Okay. So S is the product of coal combustion in the furnace along with the flue gases. Okay. So when the combustion of the coal is carried out, that is the two thing is that one is the flue gases is produced. Okay. And these flue gases are used to convert the water into the steam. Okay. And the finally the byproduct is remains. It's called as the S. About 20% of the S fall in the bottom S hopper of a boilers and is periodically removed mechanically. Okay. So here suppose furnace is there inside the boiler. Okay. So after combustions, the S is putting in this bottom part of the S hoppers and it is collected there. The S from the hopper is removed to the S storage by means of a scrap conveyors, means S handling plant, and further S is disposed of its accordance with the S disposal arrangement. Okay. So here you see this, the S is coming out. Okay. So S handling plant is there and then the finally S is stored into the storage. Okay. And this storage S is further supplied according to this requirement. So in earlier time the S is supplied in a lake or a rivers. Okay. But nowadays these S are used in number of applications for the road construction or for making the bricks. Okay. Otherwise the S is supplied in the rivers. So they are create the lots of pollutions. But nowadays the few of the scientists and engineers find it's the good way to use it. Okay. So this is the simple coal and S circuit is there. Okay, so this flue gases is coming out. So this is a line for the flue gases and this flue gases is supplied it for some purpose. Okay, that we discuss in other circuits. Now the second circuit is the air and flue gas circuits. Okay, so why its name is given the air and flue gases? Air is the input, flue gases is the output. Okay, so this air and flue circuit is the system like our inhalation system. We inhale the air and we remove the CO2. So in our human body, that is the lungs is there. Okay, in the lungs, then lungs is absorb the oxygen and supply to our full body. Okay, nowadays you already know about because of this coronavirus. Okay. So air is taken from the atmosphere by the action of a forced draft fan. Okay. So in a, that is a two type of the draft system is there. One is the forced draft and induced draft that we already discussed in the component. So I not again discuss it. Okay. So by using this FD fan, we supply this air to the boiler. Okay. And before supplying to this boiler, it passed through the air preheater where it is preheated by the flue gases. So here you see this is the diagram. This is FD fan is there. FD fan is push the air first in the air preheaters. Okay. In the air preheaters, the temperature of the air is increased and then after it is supplied to the boiler. Means here preheated air is there. Okay. So we know that the air is required for the combustion of the fuel. Okay. So it is here you see that is a two input is there. That is a coal and air is there. And the third input is the water that we discussed during the water and steam circuits. The preheated air is supplied to the furnace in order to provide air for a combustion of fuels. So, for a combustion of fuels, the oxygen is required and this oxygen is taken from the air. Due to combustion of fuel, means the combustion of coal, hot gases are produced. So, this line is for the hot gases. Okay, here you see. For the preheating is, hot gases are also passed from here. The fuel gases from the furnace pass over a boiler tubes and the superheater tubes. Okay, means the fuel gases is first passing on the tubes that's provide inside the boilers. Okay, and inside the boiler tube is there, and from the tube water is passed, and of these fuel gases is passed from outside. So water is converted into the steam. Okay, then after the fuel gases is passed from the superheater, here you see, in the superheater what happen? The temperature of the steam is increased. Then the fuel gases is passed through the economizers. Okay, so here you see, this is the economizers. In economizers we increase the temperature of the waters, and then after it is passed from the air preheaters. Okay, so here you see, this fuel gases is passed from the air preheaters. The fuel gases is then passed through dust and fly ash collector device, where the suspended dust and the fly ash are removed from it. So here you see in the diagram, that is a dust and fly ash collector is that, means from the fuel gases, dust and fly ash is collected here, and then after the fuel gases is supplied to some atmosphere or some other components. The fly ash is separated from the fuel gases by means of a S precipitators. Okay, we also study about the air precipitators in the component video. Okay, so in S precipitator, fly ash is removed. For dust collector, some other mechanisms are used. Then finally, fuel gases is exhausted to the atmosphere through the chimney. So here you see, the exhaust gases is supplied to the chimney, and from the chimney it is supplied to the atmospheres. Okay. Now, what is the reasons behind of that the superheater fuel gases is first passed from the superheater, then economizer, and from the air preheaters? Okay. So these are the basic reason is that because in the superheater temperature of the steam is higher. Okay. So we are require higher temperature. So when these exhaust gas removed from the boiler, it have higher temperature. Okay. So when these flue gas temperature is utilized in superheater and flue gas temperature is further reduced, then it is used to heat the waters, and then after it is used to heat the air. Okay. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to power plant engineering and other subject of this mechanical engineering. For more video, I request to visit the playlist, even you check the cards as well as the descriptions. Now here we complete the two circuit. Now third circuit is the water and steam circuit. Okay, same way we drink the waters and we remove the waters. Okay, our human body are not removing the steam, but it's remove the water with some impurities. Okay, so instance of starting this water and steam circuit from the water, I just start the system from the steam. Okay, because they are more reliable to understand from the steams. Okay, so in a boiler we supply this water. Okay, this water is supplied from these economizers. Okay, so feed water is supplied from these economizers to the boilers. That line we discuss later on. Just we start from the steam. Okay, so this saturated steam is supplied to the superheater. Okay, in the superheater what happened? The temperature of the steam is further increased. Further increase means the temperature of the steam is increased above the saturation temperature of the steam. Then after, this superheated steam is supplied to this turbine. Okay, in the turbine what happen? The energy of the steam is converted into the mechanical energy. Means in a turbine there is a number of rotor is there. Okay, there is a three stages of the turbine that we study: high pressure stage, intermediate pressure stage, and low pressure stage is there. So here some mechanical energy is produced. Okay, so this mechanical energy produced by the turbine is supplied to this generator. And generator is produced the electricity. Okay, means here we have the chemical energy of a coal is converted into this electricity. Okay, then after steam coming out, means exhaust steam coming out from the turbine is supplied to this condenser. So condenser is one type of the heat exchanger. Its name is condenser because there is a condensation process is going on inside there. Condensation process means the steam is converted into the liquid. Okay, so, or it is called as the condensate. So condensate is coming out. So this condensate is supplied to this pump, and from the pump it is supplied to the LP feed water heater, means low pressure feed water heaters. Why its name is given the low pressure feed water heaters? Because heating this water coming out from the condenser, okay, we need to heat it. For heating this water, we take the steam from the stage of the steam turbine, that is a low pressure. Okay, so here low pressure stage is there, in between intermediate state, and here high pressure stage is there. Okay, so we take the some quantity of the steam and it is supplied to the LP feed water heater. So water temperature is increased. Then after it is supplied to the deorators. Deorator is used to remove the dissolved O2, means dissolved oxygen is removed by using the deorators. In the deorators, we also supply the steam from the intermediate state of the steam turbine. Okay, then after this water is supplied to the HP feed water heater. So it is again the heater, means we are increasing the temperature of water. Okay, HP means high pressure, means we take the steam from the high pressure stage of the steam turbine and it is supplied to this HP feed water, means we heat the waters by taking the steam from the high pressure stage of the turbine. Then after, this feed water is supplied to this economizer. Okay, so from this here you see, from the HP feed water, it is supplied to these economizers, and from these economizers, this preheated water is supplied to this boiler. Okay, and in the boiler, they absorb the heat energy from the flue gases, and this water is converted into the steam. Then it is supplied to the superheater, then the superheated steams, and this cycle is continuously run. Okay, now the fourth system is the cooling water system. Not the cooling water, okay, it is a cooling water, but some part is missing here. Okay, so in this system, here you see, this is the system, is water supply system is there. Okay, but sometime it is possible due to the leakage or due to the evaporations, the water quantity is reduced. Okay, so we need to add some makeup waters. Okay, so this makeup water is supplied from this river. Okay, so generally you see that's any power plant, steam power plant or gas based power plant, they are installed near to the rivers. Okay, so we take the some water from the river. Okay, and here the one pump is there, its name is the makeup water pump, and that is a water treatment plant is there. Okay, so water treatment plant is remove the impurities. Okay, and then after, this water is added here with the LP feed waters. Okay, so we need to add some waters due to this leakage or the evaporations of the water. Okay, now the fourth circuit is the cooling water circuits. Okay, so we know in the condenser the steam is converted into the water. Okay, so converting this steam into the water, we need to supply some cooling water. Okay, so from this here, in the condenser we supply some cold water. Okay, and this cold water is absorbed the heat energy from the steam, so temperature of this cold water is increased and it is called as the hot waters. Okay, now for the cooling circuit we have the two options, either use the open systems or a closed system. Okay, so if we consider this is the open system cooling water circuit, then what happen, we take the water from the river, supply to this condenser, its temperature is increased, means hot water is coming out and it is again supplied to the rivers. Okay, but the place where the water is available in a low quantity, at that time we need to use the closed circuit. Okay, so when we use the closed circuit, we need to put the cooling tower. Okay, so here you see, we putting this cooling tower. In this cooling tower, the water is spray from these throat portions. Okay, and from the lower portions, the air is in. Okay, from this lower portion of the cooling tower, air is in, water is spray here. So by using this atmosphere air, this hot water temperature is reduced. Okay, and here this air is out, so this hot water temperature is reduced and water is collected in this bottom parts of the cooling tower, and by using this pump it is supplied again. Okay, so here you see this cycle is closed, means again same water is used, that's why it's called as the closed circuits. Now here also there is a evaporation loss is there, so in the cooling tower you see that's sometimes the water is evaporated. Okay, so there is a white fumes you see. So here we again need to add the makeup waters. Okay, this makeup water is supplied from these water treatment plants. Okay, so why we need to add this makeup water, due to this loss by the evaporation process. Okay, so this is the complete diagrams of the modern layout. Okay, so we starting from the call to S circuits. Okay, so here you see this diagram with the different colors. Okay, different line color is there, so you will understand it easily. So first is call an air handling circuit, second one is the air and this flue gas circuit, third one is the water and steam circuit. So here from this river the water circuit is start and pass from this LP feed water heater, deuterators, HP feed water heater, economizers, then the steam superheater, then the superheated steam turbine exhaust and that, and fourth one is the cooling water circuit. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video, subscribe my channels, and don't forget to share with your friends.